Liam Spencer is one of the rising stars of the British art world. His views of modern urban life with their striking use of natural and artificial light have attracted international acclaim. His paintings transform ordinary humdrum scenes into eerily beautiful pools of light and movement. In this programme, Liam Spencer describes how he finds beauty in the banal, and he travels around the Northwest seeking inspiration for a scene which he has agreed to paint on camera for the first time.
Of Manchester that I've always loved, coming down the hill here, this big wide road ahead of us and the skyline of the city all laid out before us. I always loved this view as a kid when I was coming into Manchester, coming in on the bus, looking down off the top there. And I had to do this journey several times years later when I had a studio in Salford. It's a view that I'll never tire of. They won't say it. They're gonna tell ya about the young idea. Man, listen, now you said you're bitter.
At 41, Liam Spencer could belong to the Brit art pack of Damien Hirst and Tracy Emin, but while his subject matter is contemporary, it is his technical skill as an artist that is attracting national attention and creating growing demand for his work.
I don't think there was ever a point where I thought, I want to be an artist. I think there was perhaps various creative things that I would have liked to have been involved in. And perhaps by a process of elimination, I ended up with the one thing that I've pursued. I think I was a slow starter, really, or a slow burner. So I think there were more talented people around. And I always think there's a balance, really, between talent and sort of, I don't know, tenacity. I don't know, if you're going to survive as an artist, you have to be quite kind of bloody-minded about it. I've never been watched making a painting before. I've certainly never been filmed making a painting before. And it's quite a nerve-wracking experience. I always find it quite a struggle, so I suppose it's a question of being watched struggling with this activity that's a bit off-putting. Usually if you're working and it doesn't work out, it doesn't really matter, you know, in that you can either discard it or start again or just leave it and come back to it. So there isn't usually the same pressure to try and make something work, you know.
Later in the programme, we'll see whether Liam's struggle pays off, whether he can work under the unforgiving eye of a camera. Although he's often described as a Manchester artist, Liam was born and grew up in the outskirts of Burnley. He now lives in the Rossendale Valley with his wife Heather and sons Hugh and Tom. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends.
Right, you've got him. Well done. Walk with me, Susie.
But when I grew up in Burnley, I think like most kids, I was more interested in football and messing about and fishing, really. And didn't take too much notice of my surroundings. But I remember the mills and the cotton mills were just still working when I was young, although it came to an end shortly after that. But I think it was sort of moving to Manchester and starting to study art. I think that's when I started to become more aware of the surroundings.
After an art foundation course at Burnley College, Liam arrived at Manchester Polytechnic in 1983, just as the city was going through a musical and artistic renaissance. The city that had excited him as a child now provided the landscapes for his work.
I think it was in the second year at college, really, where when I started to find my feet. This was in Manchester at the Polytechnic.
I think the thing that struck me most was all the warehouses, really, and the mill buildings to a lesser extent, and just these, you know, sort of wonderful red brick structures. That made a big impression. I like the fact that canals run right through the heart of Manchester, and although they're slightly hidden, certainly less so now, but at that time they were. And you just had this kind of linear oasis through the city, really, and, you know, in the sort of roughest parts of Ancoats or something, there'd be like moorhens pottering along the side of the canal, and that was nice. And I think just literally because it was a quiet spot as well, and I could get out and I could paint outside without being pestered. Water's always an attractive subject, really, because it's got this, you know, illusionism, I suppose, of the reflections and the movement, and it just creates lots of dynamic rhythms.
I like it here. It does remind me of how it used to be, derelict, and you'd have the place to yourself. And just these really lovely old mill buildings and warehouses, particularly at this time on a, you know, a lovely bright sunny evening. It's just the low sunlight and all the red brick just gets really accentuated by the sun. Felt like an outdoor studio at one time. I just spent so much time by the lock gate. Having seen it again now, it'd be nice to try and grab something of it before it changes forever.
As a young art student, Liam used to carry his paints with him to work in situ amidst the canals and mills of Manchester. These days he catches his images on camera, something he began when his children were growing up so he could catch them in natural poses without them having to sit for hours on end. To steal what you never could own, and race from this hole she calls home.
I don't want to recreate a photograph in paint. I don't really see the point, really, for me. It still has to be a painting, and it has to be about brush marks and paint and texture and colour and things like that. The rain falls hard on a humdrum town. This town has dragged you down.
At this stage, Liam has little idea where the inspiration for his painting will come from. It partly explains his appeal, that he can find it in the most unexpected places.
I think there is, for me, there's an added interest in perhaps finding something that is mundane or potentially ugly and perhaps noticing it in a certain light and then transforming that into something which is perhaps quite beautiful if the painting works as it should. And I spend a lot of time taking photographs, looking at them afterwards, sifting through them, and then the painting process then begins. Once upon a time, not too long. I suppose I'm always looking for that sort of beauty in unexpected places. I think the IMO car wash was just completely fortuitous, or what's the word, opportunistic, really. Just drawing up alongside it in the car and just seeing this thing, and I don't know whether it was just sort of glowing, really, and just looking quite enigmatic. To some extent, the subject matter, it's not insignificant, but it could be anything. And, you know, whether it is, you know, Manhattan skyline or a burger bar in Burnley, it doesn't it doesn't really matter, you know, I don't think there's any kind of hierarchy there of one subject being more important than another. It's just whatever happens to make an impression at the time.
Few things in Manchester are less obviously beautiful than the Mancunian Way, a concrete flyover that bisects the southern part of the city centre and used to wind its way outside Liam's studio in Hanover Mill. That's been knocked down, but on a stairwell in the student accommodation block that now stands there, Liam was reunited with the trademark view. Would this be the scene to inspire his new painting?
It's been about 5 years since I stood in this spot looking out on this view in the building that preceded this one. It's odd to be back again, looking out on the same view. It's a bit like travelling back in time.
The skies were different virtually every night, so you got some very intense sunsets, and that combined with the electric light and reflections and movement and speed and noise, and you know, you can't ignore it.
I don't know whether it will result in any more paintings, but it's nice to see it again.
Liam's views of the Mancunian Way formed a major part of his exhibition at the newly opened Lowry Centre in 2000. It marked a turning point in his career. All his paintings sold and have continued to do so ever since.
I think the Lowry exhibition was the most significant single event because the place had just opened, lots of people visited it, so as a consequence the exhibition that I had there right from the opening day was really well attended, so it was just the sort of platform for the work was just so much greater really. And yeah, that made a huge difference because the exhibitions that have taken place since then have had a sort of ready-made audience for them really, of people wanting to see the work. It's an interesting situation where there is a big demand for what you do, and I think in some ways that creates a new challenge. For a long time the challenge was to continue to be an artist in quite difficult circumstances, you know, with no money and you know, occasional interest in the work but nothing that significant. And I think now that situation has changed and there is a lot of interest in the work, I think you have to be sort of equally focused in a way, not to be drawn into, well, let's do another one because someone wants it, you know, to sort of keep doing it for the right reasons and to do it with conviction.
The time has come for Liam to find inspiration for the painting he has agreed to produce for the programme. As well as the Mancunian Way, he's agreed to revisit some of the scenes that in the past have stirred his interest.
I am a passenger, and I ride through the city backsides. I see the stars come out of the sky.
This is my old stamping ground around here. I used to have a studio just the other side of the bridge there, so I've seen this junction in most lights at different times of the day, and this is probably about my favourite, where it starts to fall dark and the lights start to come on, and I've done a few paintings around this area. Well, it's always nice when it's been wet and then you get a bit of sunlight, and that happened earlier this evening, and that's often quite appealing, a sort of rich colour that's not there without the rain.
I think it's on the fringes of things, but it's still got quite a nice atmosphere to it, I think, because there's the railway lines and everything, and it's just into Salford, the other side of the river, and it just feels, it's got a slightly different feel to it.
From Salford to a high-rise in Stockport next to the M60 motorway, which Liam has travelled many times in recent years.
I've painted in Stockport before and I still like that journey around the M60 as you start to approach Stockport and all the tower blocks and mills, and that's quite a nice dynamic subject matter.
Well, it's nice for me, having spent so much time in the centre of Manchester, actually seeing it from such a distance and from such a height. And it's nice having this sort of vast panorama to enjoy, really, and see how it changes as the light starts to fall. And it's changing quite quickly now. Manchester's just starting to light up a bit in the distance, which is quite nice. It's just starting to go dark now, so all the artificial lights are coming on, so it's there's very little daylight left. And I think as it starts to change now, I'll become much more aware of the artificial light and the headlights, and that can have a charm of its own as well. I think it's this very thin strip now of the skyline that's starting to look quite good, which might suggest a sort of long panoramic painting, so that's probably the most likely outcome, but I'll keep you posted.
On the road again, this time to the Mersey estuary, and a familiar landscape to travellers on the M56 that has often intrigued him.
Just near Widnes, and we're looking along the canal towards the petrochemical works, and it's a place that I've seen in passing on the motorway several times, and it's nice to come and explore it a bit closer and have a good look at it. It's an odd place, really. It shouldn't be, but it's just really stunning at this time of night. I suppose it's in many ways something that's kind of unpleasant, you know, petrochemical industry and pollution and everything associated with it, but there's no doubting how great it looks, especially at night, and it just seems to get nicer and nicer as the light starts to fall.
I suppose I'm always looking for that sort of beauty in unexpected places. You've been praying for rain, drench your soul in the water, cleanse your heart of the stain, cleanse your heart of the stain.
And finally, Liam travels home to Burnley on match night at his childhood theatre of dreams, which still excites, even if the football doesn't reach the heights of years gone by.
We're outside Turf Moor and it's almost kick-off time and the light's starting to fade. It's this sort of evening that I've done some paintings of. Something about the atmosphere of the night matches and the artificial lights that appeals to me as a painter and as a football fan as well.
I've been a Burnley fan since I was a kid, really, and first started going to the matches when I was about 10 or 11 years old. And you know, I think it's all the stuff that goes with it, really, you know, the burger bars and the chip shops and the badge sellers and all that. It's all part of the colour of it.
Usually, Liam will spend weeks, if not months, sifting through his digital images in search of the ideal moment of light, colour and movement. On this occasion, it's the morning after his last recce.
It's been an interesting few days, that's for sure, and it's been quite busy. I feel like my feet have hardly touched the floor.
It's difficult having to decide which one is going to become the subject of the painting for the film. But strangely enough, I've ended up on sort of familiar territory, on the streets in Salford, just around the corner from where I used to have a studio.
I think it's just the different elements within it. So I think it's just the rhythm, really, across the span of the picture.
Even when working on a large landscape like the one he's chosen, Liam will only take between 3 and 4 hours to complete a first draft of the painting.
I'm just transferring the basic composition from the photograph, the photo montage, onto the board that I'm going to paint on. So I just have this grid over the top just to square it up, and then just very lightly draw a grid on the board, and then just transfer the very simple composition. I don't like to get too much pencil on the board because even that can muck up the colours a little bit. So.
In the crackle of night. You now, if this is not hate, I don't know how.
I like working on board because I like that sort of solid surface, really, because I like the brush marks to be very evident, and that happens more on a hard surface like board. I like to try and get as much down as possible in the first hour or two, really. Depends on the size of the painting as well. Your honor. If I can try and get most of it done within one session, I'd be happy, and then perhaps to come back to it later. I think the subject matter dictates the treatment in a way, and I suppose that I have over a period of years been more drawn to sort of expansive landscapes, I suppose, where you can see the sky and the light and the changes, and it's only sort of relatively recently that I've started to zoom in a little bit more and perhaps find just little sort of more intimate things, I suppose, like a chip shop or a burger bar. But I think it's still about light and colour, and you know, this, I suppose, the specifics of this little burger bar with the light inside on a, you know, on an evening or at dusk or something, and I think that's what appeals to me, really. I think you just learn to see different things as well, don't you, in a way that I think if you see the work of an artist, you then go outside and you see the world slightly differently. And I think you'll sort of start to see that for yourself as well. So I may perhaps do one painting at a pub, and then I'll suddenly start noticing other ones that might become the subject of a painting. So it's, you know, I think it's just little sort of breakthroughs, I suppose, that then allow you to see that as potential subject matter, whereas you might have happily ignored it a while before.
William Spencer has been compared to Ellis Lowry, another artist famed for his northern industrial landscapes. But apart from the subject matter, their styles are very different.
I think the comparisons with Lowry are inevitable, really, because he, you know, I suppose he pioneered making art about the industrial north, and in some ways I've picked up on that. But I also think with Lowry, he was more of a kind of visionary sort of artist, that he was imposing his own vision on the landscape, and would often construct a landscape really from memory and imagination. And I suppose in that sense my work is perhaps closer to Impressionism, in that I'm sort of responding to what's there and changing light and colour and weather conditions. Well, I'm not very happy with it, but then I rarely am when I'm actually working on it, so it's fairly normal. It's a fairly frustrating experience usually, painting. It's literally quite a slippy medium oil paint, and so it's quite elusive, and the painting can come and go quite quickly. Like, it can look quite good one minute, and then the next minute it can just sort of slip away, and then it's a question of trying to bring it back again. And it's just I think it's a constant tension, really. It's the way that I'm working is sort of making brush marks and trying to get them in the right place and the right colour and the right tone and doing the right thing in terms of space. And it's quite a balancing act trying to get all that to work together. And it is literally slippy, it comes and goes. And that's all I can say, really. It's just a question of waiting and seeing what happens. I think that's the end of the first session, and whether it's finished or not, I'm not really sure. I don't think I'll know that until I've had a chance to get it on the wall and have a good look at it. And I think that's fairly typical of the process, really, to try and do as much as I can in one session.
After 3 days of finishing touches, Liam feels ready to invite the camera back in.
Well, I've had the chance to live with it for a while now, and I've made some adjustments, and I think it's looking more resolved. Usually when I come in through the door is when I know if there's anything wrong with it. It tends to sort of stand out and jump out at me. So I'll probably just carry on making little adjustments, and hopefully I'll come in one day and it'll look finished.
Having overcome his trial by camera, Liam seems at ease with being the observed rather than the observer.
But it's been a great experience doing this film, and it's been good fun. We've looked at some new subjects, we've gone back and visited old ones, and it's quite reassuring in a way to find that I can still look at this familiar landscape and still see it as the real subject, I think, of my work. And I think I'll continue to be inspired by the urban landscape of the northwest and Manchester.
Help us to create a picture of Britain online by submitting your digital photos at bbc.co.uk/apictureofbritain.